down to number one, and the most common thing I'm seeing, the happiest patients, and it does take a little bit of volume, but it's rejuvenation. And everyone's worried about the downturn mouth, and we talked about PDO threads. That can lift beautifully. But a lot of people lose bone here. And the angle of the jaw, if we fill along here, it pulls back. It helps prevent the downturn of the mouth or the RBF that people don't like. And I did video using Kybella. We use PDO threads and also rejuvenating people, because the bone loss at the angle of the jaw, and it can be 2 to 3 vials per side, but it looks gorgeous. Here's a couple points in this procedure. And I had the opportunity to do cadaver dissections with the top people in the country and top anatomists. And we were able to inject product and look at it after we injected it and see where the product went, what were the best products, and the plane and the depth to go. There was some controversy going deep to the masseter or superficial. The fat layer above the masseter is where you want to be. Now, these videos aren't for training. They're for concepts to educate people. Certainly, there's the parotid gland, the parotid duct. You have your masseter here, and of course, bone. You have your facial nerve. This is not meant to tell you how to do it. I'm telling you what to do, and definitely using a larger microcannula is amazing. It's quicker and safer than using a needle. So there's a lot of anatomical considerations in this area, but very satisfying procedure, amazing results. It does many things. It pulls back the edge of the mouth. It creates a strong jawline. You can drop some Kybella into the edge of the jawline, but it does take typically 1 to 3 vials per side, but it's worth it because it's a natural, beautiful look and patients love it. If the patient starts square, and we already said the triangle of Booth becomes the pyramid of age, if the patient's already square, you cannot get gain from filling the edge of the jawline in the masseter area because it's already too big compared to the numbers in the upper face. So building the cheeks and the temple has to be done first. Or if there is bone loss here and the numbers are perfect in the upper face, certainly adding it here. But don't square female patients. Males can be a little more square, not females per se. As a general rule, everyone is a little differently aesthetic, and some people can get away. The lip dimension also determines how wide they can be in the jawline. So it's about understanding beauty, but rejuvenation is an amazing procedure. And 10 to 15 years ago, we weren't really filling jawlines. We didn't have the products that lasted, and we didn't have the microcannulas or the concepts of lifting here. We were focusing on the frowns and learning about toxins and filling cheeks. But now the jawline is in play. So thanks for joining me today. There's top 5 trending aesthetic procedures that I see, not only globally, but in America and North America. With social media around the world, the treatments, the ideas, and the concepts are becoming more congruent. Whereas 10 years ago, what we were doing in Europe, America, Asia was much different. But it's becoming one world with more concepts that are understood by all and sought out by majority of people. So thanks for joining me today. Join us on this YouTube channel. Subscribe for continued helpful tips. Also on Instagram for more before and afters. Also to find out about the courses, sign up at aesthetictrainingcenter.com to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.